for example, let us know about the drop in oil. What happened in Egypt when the oil dropped from the hundreds to the $30-$40 mark?
In 2014, you know that we had another revolution in 2013. Okay, so our country was not very good, wasn't in a very good shape in the economic way. Our country depends greatly on the foreign investor. Okay, to invest their money, but who would invest his money in a nation that have two revolution in 3 years, and there were no securities, the security forces. Have been weakened. Okay, there was a great chaos in Egypt in that period, in 2014. In addition, the oil prices dropped from $100 to $40. So the oil companies in Egypt stopped to employ a new engineers and a new, stopped to take a new employees. And in 2014 was the last, in Egypt, when we wanted to join a job, to get a job in an oil company, you would have to pass an exam. Okay, this exam is made by the Ministry of Oil and the Natural Resources. The ministry last exam was in 2014. The ministry hadn't had any exams since 2014. And also because we get a loan from the IMF, the International Monetary Fund, Egypt needed a big loan. So they told our government that we shall reduce the number of public sector employees because the salaries of them are very big. This is what happened. In 2014 was a great chaos in Egypt and the oil prices, and the IMF had told us they won't give us a loan unless we dropped the number of the public employee, and oil companies are public companies.
Mostly of the oil, let's say, works are government dependent, or do you have private companies as well?
Actually, it is a mix of that and that. My father was an employee of a company called Jabco. Jabco, it is an oil, it is 50% British Petroleum and 50% Egypt. Most of our oil companies are like that, 50% foreign investor and 50% is Egyptian government.
Okay, I see, I understand now. So it's like a conjunct investment in order to have, and I think also employees are mostly Egyptians, or do they also have, like, for instance, BP has English people or so?
Yes, English people. Okay, I had a summer training in BP or in Jabco, with the previous year. There were British men there and they were speaking English fluently. Yes, it is 50% British and 50% Egyptian.
Check out the full episode at chemicalengineeringguy.com/forward podcast. I'll see you there.